Hi everyone, thanks for joining us here again for another Tooltip Tuesday. Hope you're having a great day. And today we're going to show you how to use the Tool Wizard a little bit further, and that's to create an internal turning tool using the wizard. Once we select the option of internal turning tools, it brings up a page where we can then define a little bit further of the style of tool we want to do. So we have grooving tools, threading tools, chamfering tools, but today we're going to concentrate on the boring tools. We can select the shank diameter and the cut type, and then the next few pages allow us to put in the detail or the parameters that define the tool. So here we have the top dimensions, the side dimensions. We can change things like corner radius, angles, clearance angles, and the next page brings up the front tool dimensions, so some reliefs, heights, etc. The final page brings us to the operations page, so here we can select the operations we want to grind, whether we want to have a coolant groove, we want to cut the shank off, put a chamfer on the back, etc. And we can manipulate some of these parameters to define the type of tool we want. Once we're happy with those parameters, we then select our wheels. You may have to play around with the wheels a little bit to get the correct wheels for the tool you're trying to create. And as a reference, if there's a wheel that it won't pre-select, it gives us the option here and says, yeah, we require a 1A1 or etc. Once we're happy with our wheels and we continue, the wizard basically builds a program around our parameters that we've entered, and there we have a internal boring tool directly from the wizard. Hope you have a great day, guys. Thanks for tuning in, and we'll see you next time.